Hey guys, so it's a beautiful snowy day in British Columbia, and today we're going to show you a little bit of a snow challenge. We're going to use a real world scenario. Got our driveway here. Not really trekked on, not too polished yet, and I got four vehicles, and we're going to see what they do on the driveway. We got a two-wheel drive truck here with a locker and snow tires and studs. Run-of-the-mill front-wheel drive car with all seasons on it. Two-wheel drive van, all seasons on it with traction control, and we have a 4x4 truck with all terrains on it. This is just to simulate a real world scenario where you're at a traffic light on a hill and you're stopped and you want to know, can your vehicle just move from a dead stop or do you always need momentum? So I'm going to be pretty fair on this test. You can see here that there is still some fresh snow, so I'm going to give the van and the car first run, and we're going to put them in the fresh snow as opposed to on the polished surface where the vehicle's already trekked up.
Second gear right now to slow down the rotation of the tires. Kind of bald. This driveway's pretty slick. No go. So it's got G80 locker, snow tires with studs on it. Anyway, so second gear, it slows down the rotation. I'm on the polished stuff. Drive. I'll even stop right here. more of an angle. This does just claw it right into the pavement. Engage the diff locker, we're still in two-wheel drive though in second gear. Much better. You can see my problem here is that really the tires, it's just polishing the surface. It's not moving at all because it's just on top, it's not digging down. These are off-road tires, all terrains, but much better so far. Engage four-wheel drive.
So as you can see in our real-world test, with a different variety of powertrain layouts, probably the biggest factor you noticed was tire selection. Now remember, this is just a moving test. These vehicles, you still have to stop. Imagine going down a hill. A lot of these vehicles without the snow tires aren't gonna stop that well, and the studs really help. I'll even show you here now. So you see here, this is all polished from vehicles moving on it. This is the Silverado with the studded tires. You see, it just claws and claws and claws till it actually hits pavement. That's how it gets traction, then it gets momentum and then moves up. The Frontier kind of did the same thing. It was harder for it to dig down, but with the traction control, it was a little bit kind of uncertain of what it was wanting to do. You really have to use four-wheel drive on that truck with those tires, especially with no weight in the back. Back here, you see, this is where the van and the Protege were. They just can't dig. You know, if you're gonna be driving this stuff, you gotta be using the right tires. Remember, all seasons don't even work after like 5 degrees Celsius, much less zero. They really harden up. They work, but they don't work that well. I've seen people that roll around here in summer tires. You guys need to get off the road, plain and simple. You're way too dangerous. This is a very low speed test, and these vehicles were going sideways up this driveway. So you can see, tires are extremely important, and so are traction devices such as traction control, differential lockers, or limited slip make a huge difference as well.